start.
Today, the world is celebrating the International Human Rights Day, which is marks the coming to force of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights Document of 1948, Geneva Convention. So, what is a human right? Human right is a right which is essential right, fundamental right for survival of the human being is called a human right. We cannot give a clear-cut definition of the human rights. The rights which pertain to man for his survival is called as human rights. The human rights and the International Charter is concerned. As you know, that International Charter has come into force from the 24th of October 1945. The Charter specifically provides under the preamble part that it reaffirms the faith and the human rights. And there is one article 13 is there in the UN Charter which says that economic, social, political and cultural rights of the individuals around the world has been treated as the human rights. And basing upon this, the state parties, they cannot discriminate upon the color, race, sex, language, religion. Whatever color, whatever race, whatever language, whatever religion, all are equal. Every state party has to incorporate these principles in their domestic laws. As per that, India also incorporated under the Constitution of India under Article 14, 15 and 16 specifically. With regard to the other articles of the UN Charter is concerned, which deals with the human rights, are Article 62 and 68. This article says that state parties have to promote and encourage respect for human rights, because these are the fundamental rights which have been enumerated from birth of the human being. So every state party has to respect and promote and encourage the human rights. In addition to that, we have the Article 55 is there, which speaks about the human rights has to be observed, respected in every way. And Article 55 and 56 binds upon the states, UN Charter states, that to observe and respect human rights at any cost. For that reason, they have to make the laws, domestic laws, creating the respect for the human rights. In addition to that, we have the Article 76, Clause Number C is there, which encourages that state parties have to respect the human rights at all circumstances. As per that UN Charter, which is providing a very significant role in protection of the human rights, the United Nations, under the aegis of its principal organ, Economic and Social Organization, a separate body is created, which is named as United Nations Human Rights Commission. In February 1946, the main function of this body to observe, protect, encourage human rights around the world. All the signatories to this document, this covenant, has to follow the human rights in two spirits. The UN Commission on Human Rights specifically has 43 members, and the 43 members have selected every 3 years term, and every year the UN Human Rights Commission sits for 5 to 6 weeks, and as you well aware that its headquarters are situated in Geneva, Switzerland. So there is specifically one important aspect is there with regard to this United Nations Human Rights Commission, that any person in the world, if there is a violation of human rights of him, such person, on behalf of such person, a petition can be filed in the United Nations Commission. So that means that individuals also become the party under the international law. This is a specific provision which is there in the UN United Nations system. So, because of the efforts made by the United Nations organization, under the aegis of the United Nations organization, again, a covenant on the Universal Declaration of Human Rights of Geneva 1948 is enacted, and December 10th is a date where it came into force. So UN is playing a very, very vital role in upholding the human rights around the world.